in my case, I'm teaching at many levels, 7, 9, 10. So technically, I prepare different instructional materials because I can use my materials in grade 10 to grade 7, different level. So when you ask how do I prepare, first I study the lesson. Because when you study the lesson, it's the time that you will know the proper instructional material that you are going to use. And then you are going to evaluate if that instructional material fits your students. Right. When we talk about principles, I usually do not answer that in a textbook manner or in a traditional way. For me, kasi, the principles of instructional materials, first, it should be practical. When I say practical, you use the available materials. As a teacher, you should be resourceful. That's one thing I remember from a teacher. Second, it's durable. When we say durable, for example, we are going to use at 7 a.m. in the morning. Your material should at least last until their last period, until 3 p.m. So that's what we call a durable instructional materials. Third, it should be significant. When we say significant, it is connected with the student. It fits the student. It fits the needs of the student. Fourth is, it should be connected with the curriculum, the needs of the curriculum. Now we are using a spiral curriculum in KFL. So you should answer all the needs or all the concepts that the curriculum is looking for.
How do you utilize the
spiral curriculum? Utilize the in classroom, I seldom use instructional materials. First, because I'm using whiteboard marker, because I'm more on the learning by doing process, where the students collaborate for them, for them to learn. So when I use instructional materials, this material, the topics that I choose to have a material is the topics that is very what do you call this? Very hard for the students to understand. Because if it's hard for the students to understand, the concepts and the theory should be posted in the board so that they could have at least a glance or a glimpse of what am I talking about. And also, when I use instructional materials in the classroom, I consider the level of intelligence of the students and yung tinatawag natin sa sitting arrangement, wherein you can see there all the students at the back if they can see your discussion.
Which do you prefer to use, the traditional
instructional
material or the modern traditional
instructional material? Actually, used to, but when it comes to preference, I prefer the modern. Because we have so many applications now that are downloadable in the internet, wherein it's very collaborative and it's very modern in a sense that you can go through the lesson. It's like a walkthrough to the lesson. But it's very easy, it's very affordable because it's free, and also it's effective and efficient.
How is the
very evident, the evolution of instructional materials is very evident. Yourself, you can see that. We began with a chalk and eraser and the blackboard. From that, the vanilla paper, the cartolina, and then there are these modules, and then now we are using AVR, the laptop, the projectors, and now even the private schools has their tablets, wherein all the lessons are there, and the teacher's role is just talk. Facilitate the learning. So that's how I see the evolution of instructional materials. And the evolution of the instructional materials is from teacher-centered to student-centered.
okay. As a teacher, ang kahalagahan ng instructional materials, parang best friend mo yan. You cannot teach without visual aids. So, as far as the question na evolution ng visual aids, when I started teaching way back 2003, ang ginagamit namin ay mostly, syempre, ay manila paper, cartolina, and pencil pen with matching texto kasi noon hindi pa yung provided na DepEd. So, as years goes, natutuhan, nauso ang laptop. Nauso ang laptop, mas napadali nito yung buhay ng isang teacher dahil sa PowerPoint presentation. Ngayon din, matapos ng PowerPoint presentation, nag-evolve ulit ang learning process. So, from pencil pen and Manila paper, nagkaroon ng whiteboard and whiteboard marker. So, pili ko mas maganda yun kaysa sa chalk and blackboard dahil yung ilan may allergy, gaya ko. So, never akong gumamit ng chalk sa pagtuturo kasi nga meron ko allergy. Tapos, nauso yung tablet. So, may nauso din way back 2010. Nauso yung Clipper. Nauso yung Edmodo. So, nagamit namin yun as our additional instructional materials para sa mga bata. So, nauso din ang Facebook. Nag-evolve. Vlog, ginagamit na din namin yun dito sa school. YouTube, ginagamit na natin yun. So, masasabi ko sa 21st century learning, ang bata, ang sentro. So, dahil ang bata ang sentro doon, si teacher facilitator. So, dahil facilitator, si teacher, gumagamit kami ngayon ng graphic organizer. Makikulong yung mga graphic organizer. Marami yan sa internet na nadadownload. Ako personally, meron ako mga graphic organizer every lesson. Every pagtalakay ng aralin, meron ako sinisituit ko na ang bata ay gumagamit ng graphic organizer. Makikulong siya. So, palagay ko, yun yung kailangan para masabi natin na maging student learner. Maging student learner yung curriculum. Pagkatapos, idagdag mo pa yung LRMDS na pinapatupad ngayon na Division of Magtangob. Actually, yung Division of Magtangob. So, ang LRMDS, so, pinuprovide niya kami ng mga instructional materials na ginawa ng iba't ibang teachers sa buong Pilipinas. So, one way or another, makatutulong ito sa amin kapag wala kami sources ng mga materials for student learning. So, sa palagay ko, yan yung pinakabago. Yes,
sir.
Pagdating sa student-centered learning, pagdating sa issue na yan, dati kasi si teacher yung nabispimput ng mga sagot, di ba? Ng mga lahat ng bagay, binibigay ni teacher. So, ngayon sa student-centered, meron silang laya. They have the freedom na sabihin kung ano yung gusto nilang sabihin, palawakin, gusto nilang palawakin. Batay sa kanilang pag-unawa, batay sa kanilang ayan, batay sa kanilang perception sa isang paksa. As 21st century teacher, siguro ang role namin is to facilitate and provide. Ang mga bata is develop and enhance ang kanilang
traditional or modern, and why?
For me, I prefer the modern instructional materials because it's the new trends of the 21st century learner. But as a student teacher in GDS or in ISAP Lopez Integrated School, we utilize there the traditional instructional materials because in public school, not all schools afford to sustain the technological needs of the students.
Second question, what type of items best suit the current curriculum?
I think modern instructional materials best suit the current curriculum because, as I said a while ago, the new trend of instructional material is in the 21st century learner is the technology. But we utilize technology in teaching the 21st century learner.
Lastly, how does IMs affect the learning of the students?
Instructional materials affects the learning of the students by all means because instructional material is the most basis and the most important basis of the students in learning and acquiring.
Also the modern one, because I think students tend to understand the lesson more effectively. he or she will not be succeeding in teaching his or her lessons in the class. So, because I think that teachers also want to have the learners the knowledge from them. I think that's
which do you prefer to use? Like, is it traditional one or like
it? As of now, for me, I prefer using the traditional and technology nowadays, because we know that traditional technology is the materials used inside the classroom, like pen and paper, blackboards, or chalkboards. That are used by the teachers, and also it is the materials included is also the cartolinas and the papers. So educational medias are the emerging technologies of the day. So example of this are PowerPoint presentations, projectors, the videos that are available on YouTube, and some podcasts that can be heard by the students. Because educational medias or the emerging technologies today are from the traditional technologies, which are developed by some people to be used for the convenience of all teachers when they use it to their teaching. And because teachers can use both materials at the same time. So for me, the instructional materials or IMs can be evolved based on the needs of the students and teachers. People create IM because it is convenient for them, or it is convenient to use. There are lots of trends today that are emerging in educational in education. So technologies and